when he gets married. So marriage is a union of two male and a female, two person uniting, and the combination of flesh to flesh and body to body, right? In Hindu, as per Hindu Marriage Act, marriage is a sanskar. Marriage ek sanskar chhe, right? Das sanskar chhe. Hindu ma jo janam lido, to you have a 10th sanskar. In it, marriage is a 8th sanskar. The last sanskar is Agni sanskar. Chhillo sanskar chhe Agni sanskar. So, in Hindu, marriage is a most important thing. लग्न एक जरूरियात छे, राइट? लग्न एक जरूरियात छे, फिजिकल लग्जरी नथी. एवरी पर्सनल लॉ हैज डिफरेंट डेफिनेशन फॉर मैरिज, राइट? फॉर मुस्लिम मैरिज हैज अ डिफरेंट डेफिनेशन, फॉर पारसी, फॉर क्रिश्चियन, एवरीबडी हैज अ डिफरेंट डेफिनेशन ऑफ मैरिज. इफ वी टॉक अबाउट हिंदू मैरिज इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड अ वेरी बेसिक रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ एन इंडिविजुअल. अ पर्सन वंस बॉर्न ही हैज टू पास थ्रू डिफरेंट संस्कार. इन इट मैरिज इज अ इम्पॉर्टेंट संस्कार, राइट? अग्नि संस्कार इज अ लास्ट संस्कार. सो विथ ही हैज टू कम विथ ऑल द संस्कार. सो इन हिंदू मैरिज इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग. इट इज नॉट जस्ट अ फिजिकल लग्जरी. It is not only a physical luxury, but is a basic requirement of a Hindu, right? So, marriage is in Hindu a sanskar, right? Prior to 1955, marriage was just a sanskar. After that, many debate had happened. Nowadays, if we go for a definition of marriage, then marriage is a sacrament. It means a sanskar and a contract. Why a contract? Why this word added in the Hindu Marriage Act? Earlier, prior to 1955, marriage was a sacrament, but now it is also a contract. Why it is a contract, right? Means this contract word is added because in Hindu there is a kanyadan, right? Kanyadan means you are giving your daughter in a gift. Kanya dan means gift, to gift anybody, right? So you are giving it in a gift. So gift is a contract, right? So Hindu marriage has now become a sacrament and a contract. If we discuss about different personal laws, then Hindu marriage is a sacrament and a contract. If we talk about Muslim, marriage is a contract, right? Marriage is a contract. If we discuss about Parsi marriage, it is a sacrament and a contract. If we discuss about the Christian marriage, it's again a contract, only a contract. And if we talk about the Special Marriage Act, if a couple has married under the Special Marriage Act, then again it is a contract, right? So different personal laws have different definition for marriage. For Hindu, it is a sacrament and a contract. Now we will see what are the requirement of a valid marriage. Lagna thava mate kai kai vastu ni jaruriyat chhe, right? Lagna thava mate ni ghani badi jaruriyat chhe. First of all, both the party, husband and the wife living together, right, should be not married. लग्न थाय त्यारे एमना पहला लग्न थयेला होवा जोईए नहीं, right? They should have not married. Second is, the marriage should not be by fraud. The couple in the marriage should not be of unsound mind. कोई भी cheating थी लग्न थवा ना होवा जोईए, and they should not be of an unsound mind. Third priority is that age. Prior to 1955, આ એક્ટ જ્યારે અમલમાં નહોતો આવ્યો ત્યારે એજ વોઝ નોટ અ લિમિટ. નાવ એજની એક બાર છે. ધ બ્રાઇડ શુડ બી ઓફ ધ એજ ઓફ 18 યર્સ એન્ડ ધ બ્રાઇડ ગ્રૂમ શુડ બી ઓફ ધ એજ ઓફ 21 યર્સ, રાઇટ? બિલો દેટ એજ ધ કપલ કેન નોટ મેરી ઇન એઝ પર ધ હિન્દુ મેરેજ એક્ટ, રાઇટ? એન્ડ they should, the couple, boy and a girl, husband and a wife, should not be under the prohibitory degree of relationship. That I discussed it, that prohibitory relation means from the father's side 5th generation and from mother's side 3 generation. So they should not come under the prohibitory degree, that is called a sapinda relation, right? So these are the basic requirement of a valid marriage. Now prior to 1955, there were many prohibition for a marriage, right? All such prohibition has been removed after this act. So this act had made a major changes. Clear? Earlier, the person, nowadays after 1955, after the commencement of 1955, Hindu Marriage Act 1955, to marry as per Hindu Marriage Act, you have to be Hindu. The most important thing is, only requirement is you have to be Hindu. Now, who are Hindus? If we talk about Hindus, then who are Hindus? All the person belonging to Jain community, Sikh community, Punjabi, Buddhist, the follower of all such religion are called Hindu, right? The person, the followers of Jain religion, Buddhist religion, right? Sikh, all are called Hindus. So the basic requirement of this act is that they have to be Hindu, right? Earlier, before 1955, such ban was not there, right? But after 1955, the basic requirement of marrying in Hindu is that the husband and a wife has to be Hindu, right? If they are from a different community, one is Parsi and one is Hindu, then they cannot marry as per Hindu Marriage Act. Then they have to marry as per Special Marriage Act, right? For marrying in a Hindu as per Hindu Marriage Act 1955, both the couple, husband and a wife, both the spouse has to be Hindu, right? That is the first requirement of a marriage as per Hindu Marriage Act, right? Same is with all the personal laws, right? If we talk about Muslim, then both the spouse has to be Muslim. Both the spouse has to be Muslim, right? Otherwise, Muslim boy or Kitabi bai, that is a Muslim type of wife, is fine. But otherwise, in Muslim personal law also, if you want to marry as per Muslim Marriage Act, husband and wife, both the party, both the spouse has to be Muslim. If we talk about Parsi, then even in Parsi also, both the party, that is husband and a wife, has to be Parsi, right? If we talk about Christian, then in Christian it is different thing, right? There is some difference, that is one of the party, husband or a wife, has to be Christian. It is not required that both the party and the Christian Marriage Act has to be Christian. Yes, one of the couple has to be Christian to marry as per Christian Marriage Act. And the last is Special Marriage Act, right? When the couple is of different religion, Hindu Parsi, Hindu Muslim, then they have to marry as per Special Marriage Act, right? So under different personal laws, they have different ways of marrying. If we talk about Hindu, then both the husband and wife has to be Hindu. Second requirement is age limit, right? That we had discussed when we took the conditions of the valid marriage, that age limit for Hindu to marry as per Hindu Marriage Act, after 1955, it is 18 for a bride and for bridegroom it is 21. Prior to 1955, there was no such age bar, right? It was that after puberty, you can have a marriage. But after 1955, Hindu Marriage Act came in force. Now the age limit has been fixed. Not in Hindu, but in all the personal laws, age limit has been fixed, right? Except Muslim, Hindu, Parsi, Christian or marriage as per Special Marriage Act, the couple, bride has to be 18 and above and the bridegroom has to be 21 and above. Only in Muslim, the boy and girl has attended the age of puberty, that is 15 years, right? So these were the two requirements. The third requirement after 1955 is that the changes came is of monogamy, right? That is one wife at a time. If you want to have second wife or second marriage, then either the first marriage has been breaked because of a divorce or due to the death of a spouse, you can have a second marriage. Otherwise, Hindu Marriage Act 1955 has adopted monogamy. There was no such ban on such on the marriage before 1955. So in not only in Hindu, Parsi, Christian and under Special Marriage Act, there is a monogamy, means one husband or one wife at a time. But yes, in Muslim you can have four wife. Muslim husband can have four wife at a time, right? So these are the requirement. Second is registration. After 1955, commencement of Hindu Marriage Act 1955, registration has become compulsory, right? Registration is compulsory for Hindu, for Muslim, for Parsi, for Christian and for Special Marriage Act, right? The registration is important. Now ceremony, if we go for ceremony, Hindu marriage is done with a ceremony, that is called Saptapadi. Saat fera laine je lagna thai che, right? That is called, in Hindu we have a ceremony, right? If we go on Parsi, then they have a agreement, right? They have an agreement. In Muslim also there is an agreement, right? That the party, one will ask that kabul, one will offer a marriage and second will say kabul hai, right? Accept the marriage, then that is a procedure, right? For Special Marriage Act, it is a registration is required, right? It's like a court marriage. So different type of marriages, there is a, after 1955 major amendments had came, right? Earlier you had a school. All the Hindus throughout India were divided in two school, Mitakshara school and Dayabhagya school. Mitakshara school, where in throughout the India there was a Mitakshara school, only in West Bengal there was a Dayabhagya school. Again the Mitakshara school is divided in four part, right? Banaras school, Dravidian school, Bombay school and Vedic school. So this four head Mitakshara school were divided and Dayabhagya school were only in West Bengal. So people followers of Mitakshara school cannot marry the Dayabhagya school and the followers of Dayabhagya school cannot marry the Mitakshara school. Such ban has been abolished after 1955. After 1955, marriage, only requirement of marriage is to have a Hindu anywhere you marry, husband and wife has to be Hindu. Such school has been abolished after 1955, right? Next is about Sapinda relation we discussed, right? So the school has totally been abolished. Next, after 1955, the requirement of a valid marriage is, we had discussed, right? After 1955, many changes came. Earlier there were no concept of restitution of conjugal right. There were no concept of judicial separation. Even prior to this 1955 act, there were no clear definitions or nothing was given for a divorce, right? Mutual consent divorce or divorce by husband and wife filing divorce, any such thing were not found in the earlier act. The major act of Hindu Marriage Act came in 1955, which had, as per the situation, has changed and has brought a very new act. It is said that society changes the law or law changes the society, right? Samaj kaido ghade che kya to kaido samaj ne ghade che. Everybody is aware of this maxim that samaj kaido ghade che ke kaido samaj ne ghade che, right? We can say that Hindu Marriage Act 1955 came as a complementary of Samaj Kaida ne ghade chhe, right? Because of the different issues which were coming in the society, amendment, new act came in force, lagna ni akhi paribhasha badlai gai, chuta cheda vadhva madya, e badha karan na lidhe, right? પહેલાના જમાનામાં યુ વિલ હેવ નોટ ફાઇન્ડ ધ ડિવોર્સ. હવેના જમાનામાં ઇટ હેઝ બિકમ વેરી કોમન, રાઇટ? મેરેજ વોઝ સેડ એઝ અ યુનિયન ઓફ ઇનસેપરેબલ યુનિયન ઓફ મેલ એન્ડ ફિમેલ. એ બંધન છે જે છૂટતું નથી. લગ્ન એક બંધન છે જે એકવાર જોડાયા પછી છૂટતું નથી. ઇટ્સ એ ઇનસેપરેબલ બોન્ડિંગ ઓફ કનેક્ટેડ વિથ બોન ટુ બોન એન્ડ ફ્લેશ ટુ ફ્લેશ, બરાબર? એ છૂટું પડવા માંડ્યું છે અત્યારે. That has become so common કે 1955 પછી જે આ નવી એક્ટ આવી, હિન્દુ મેરેજ એક્ટ 1955, when it came in amended and has came in a very different form, આ બધા ચેન્જીસ આવ્યા છે, રાઈટ? સો ચેન્જીસ કેમ ઇન અ વેરી પોઝિટિવ વે. રેસ્ટિટ્યુશન ઓફ કોન્જ્યુગલ રાઇટ હેઝ કેમ. અર્લિયર સચ કોન્સેપ્ટ વોઝ નોટ ધેર. જ્યુડિશિયલ સેપરેશન હેઝ કેમ ઇન અ વેરી પોઝિટિવ વે. ડિવોર્સ ડે બાય ડે ઇટ ઇઝ ઇન્ક્રીઝિંગ. સો ડિવોર્સ પ્રોસીજર, ગ્રાઉન્ડ ફોર ડિવોર્સ, ઇટ્સ રિકન્સાઇલેશન, રિકન્સાઇલેશન ઓફિસર, એવરીથિંગ હેઝ કેમ અંડર ધ ન્યૂ એક્ટ, રાઇટ? સો બિંગ અ હિન્દુ, ઇફ યુ હેવ બોર્ન ઇન અ હિન્દુ ફેમિલી, યુ બિકમ અ હિન્દુ, રાઇટ? ટુ બિકમ અ હિન્દુ યુ હેવ ટુ ટેક અ બર્થ ઇન અ હિન્દુ ફેમિલી, રાઇટ? ઓર યુ કેન બી અ હિન્દુ બાય કન્વર્ઝન, બરાબર? બે પ્રકારથી થાય છે. સો હિન્દુ થવા માટે કન્વર્ઝન, ક્યાં તો બાય બર્થ યુ બિકમ અ હિન્દુ. સો હિન્દુ, બિંગ અ હિન્દુ યુ મેરી એઝ પર હિન્દુ મેરેજ એક્ટ. સો વી સી દેટ દિસ આર ધ રિક્વાયરમેન્ટ ઓફ અ હિન્દુ મેરેજ, રાઇટ? આઈ થિંક એવરીબડી વુડ બી વેરી ક્લિયર વિથ ઓલ ધ કન્ડિશન્સ ઓફ અ વેલિડ મેરેજ. This was a topic I am sure that everybody would be clear with the concept of family, its type, and what are the requirement of a family, how this concept came in force, this family structure came, the family word came from the famulus. It is a Roman word from which the famulus word family